Good afternoon. I'm Charles Gibson at ABC News headquarters in New York. There is an airplane down in the Hudson River right off Manhattan. What you're looking there is the WABC helicopter, our local station here in New York, that's zeroing in on the site. But this is a U.S. airplane that went down, U.S. Air, the airline. It is a plane that went down just a few moments ago into the river. And Robin Roberts from Good Morning America has an apartment that overlooks the Hudson River. And Robin, I gather you were looking outside the window when this occurred.
I was on the phone, Charlie, and I saw a plane that looked rather low, and it's along the flight pattern heading toward Newark. So I'm used to seeing planes, but this one was extremely low, and it was across the river. And I ran out into my balcony, and I saw it make a splash landing. It never submerged. Within, I would say, 30 seconds, I could see, because I had binoculars, I could see that the front door was, they were able to open the front door. And within a couple of minutes, water taxi, this happened to be in that direction, and I could see that it was, making its way to the airplane as fast as possible.
We have learned it is a U.S. Air flight. It is flight 1549. It goes from LaGuardia to Charlotte, North Carolina, every day. There were 23 people on board, and I have, though we haven't acquired yet a picture from the WABC helicopter, I have been able to see some shots of it, and you can tell that there are a number of passengers out on the wing. There, actually, you're getting the first view of it, and Robin, there are a number, we can just see the tail of the U.S. airplane sticking up over the water as the helicopter goes by a building right now, but there are a number of ferries right around it.
It was amazing, Charlie, to see how quickly, at first there was one, then there was a second and a third, and now it's virtually surrounded, and I can look out and see, and still, the tail is still can be seen. But it was, first of all, the landing itself, I don't know the pilot, but it was just an amazing landing and keeping control, and the fuselage never broke up or anything like that, never went under.
Did it skim?
But just how quickly people were there on the scene.
Did it skim the water, Robin, as it was going down, or did it stop?
No, it did not, Charlie. It was the strangest thing. It completely just hit the water full force, never bounced or anything like that, and came to a relatively quick stop. But it didn't skim along the water. There was a very little trauma to the aircraft. I'm still can't believe what I saw.
And it never submerged, because the river's quite deep at that point, and it never submerged.
Yes, it is quite deep. I mean, this is where the Queen Mary and other large vessels, the Intrepid, it's right around that area, and there are other large vessels that are there now too. So it's very deep. But for some reason, it never completely submerged.
Yeah,
It's still not completely submerged.
You can see that the fuselage is mostly submerged and the tail is still visible above the water. This is an Airbus 320. Well, now we can see some still pictures of it. And this is about 10 minutes ago. And you can see that the body of the airplane was above water at that point.